Julio!
That's Julio Mendoza.
Man, he's one of Denver's finest graffiti artists. What's up, brother? How you doing?
Good, man. How's it going?
You look like you have your hands full.
Yeah, Claudia asked me to create a painting for the museum's 30th anniversary.
Sick. What's it going to be about?
It's a painting that's going to tell the story of the art the museo has. So folk art, contemporary, and pre-Colombian art.
Wow. And it's going to be for sale in the auction?
Yeah, once I'm finished, it's going to be available for the auction.
Bro, people need to get their bids ready because I'm sure you're going to produce something awesome. You can find the address down in our website, right?
Yeah.
So I hope folks really bid on this. It's going to be incredible. I have a feeling it's going to be really dope.
Yeah, man. I'm excited for this.
Door for you, man.
Man, I appreciate it. Thank you.
I'll check back with you in a little bit, okay?
Right on, man. See you in a little bit.
Welcome tonight to the 30th anniversary virtual gala for the Museo de las Americas, the iconic hot pink building on Santa Fe Drive. The museo opened its door in the spring of 1991 with the mission of celebrating and promoting Latin American art and culture. For three decades, Museo has been bringing us incredible art, exhibitions, programs, events that keep our culture alive and thriving. And today, we're celebrating Museo's birthday. Thanks for tuning in and joining the party. I'm Jose Guerrero, your host for tonight. We'll talk to Museo's leaders, enjoy live art and music performances, reflect on the last 30 years, and look forward to the next 30. So get comfy, the show's about to start. I want to start this evening by welcoming Claudia Moran, Executive Director of Museo.
Thank you so much, Jose. This really is a special night for us at Museo. Thanks to everyone for helping us celebrate our birthday. Museo has grown so much since we have started 30 years ago. And we have Jose Aguayo, Patty Ortiz, and Maruca Salazar to thank for their visionary leadership. Jose is awaiting for us in the Ancient American Gallery to share with us the highlights of his leadership. I have got to get back to planning for our next exhibition. Hasta luego.
When I told my wife, Magdalena, that I was going to quit my job and open a museum, she thought I was crazy. She decided that she would support my dream. We, along with six members of our extended family, incorporated the Museo de las Americas. That was in April 1991. But I had this idea going around in my brain for quite some time. We organized initially exhibits featuring local Chicano artists, and they would donate a portion of the sales of their artwork to the museo to help us get started. Gradually, I added talented staff to take over some of those duties. We were able to present exhibits showcasing the art, history, and culture of Colorado, Mexico, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean. By the beginning of the 21st century, the museo had become a destination point for nearly 500,000 visitors a year. And half of those visitors were students from schools throughout Colorado, and even some from bordering states, Wyoming, Nebraska, and New Mexico. I was very proud of that because it was really something to see the school buses pull up daily to the museo and have their students go through and learn something about Latino history, art, and culture. In 1998, we held the museo's first annual fundraising gala. And actress Rita Moreno graciously agreed to keynote that first gala. Irving and Eleanor, and we established a rapport, and they decided to make the museo the repository for their collection. You know, I was ecstatic at that point to learn that they were also going to give us an endowment in the future, you know, to maintain and develop the collection. I mean, that was like extra icing on the cake, you know. I didn't expect it, but it was gave me a sense that that would be a very important piece in giving the museo some stability and allowing us to continue into the future. Well, my initial vision was to create a museum that would showcase the art, history, and culture of all of Latin America. Going forward, I hope that the museo continues to see education of our young people about Latino art, history, and culture as a very important part of their mission. There is nothing more satisfying than to see children come into a museo like this and be dazzled and, you know, amazed at what they see and what they didn't know about Latinos and their history and culture. It makes me so proud to be able to see the museo celebrating its 30th anniversary. I'm so proud of that, and so gratified, you know, that it has survived and it has a very bright future.
Museo is a very unique institution. It's through its exhibitions, it's proven that it is certainly on par with other museums here in the Rocky Mountain region, certainly in the United States and really throughout the world. It is extraordinary what it's put on exhibits here at Museo. When you're at an exhibition at Museo, it is always about community. It's always about something intrinsic to how we all got here. Each exhibition, each piece, is a story. And each of those stories is uniquely told by that curator. And so I guess that Museo has been very fortunate in being represented by people who are good storytellers and people who have that richness of culture that they bring to light. Civic engagement is very important on all levels, and everybody has to should find anyway, something that really appeals to them in terms of just giving back. We're all too eager to take, and so many times we forget to give. Museo de las Americas was a very unique in that it broadened. It wasn't just a museum or just a place to come in and look at pictures. This was much more community. And not everybody understands that $1 can mean can make a great deal of difference. So my hopes are that we continue, the museo continues to develop more community relations, expands its educational programming, expands summer camp, involvement with teaching programs, with intern programs, offering all sorts of people different viewpoints of Museo and really making it for what it really is and showing it for what it is. I have to take a step back. I have to listen. I'm being invited into somebody else's home and somebody else's environment and somebody else's community and somebody else's culture. And I did. And I will tell you that it's not so much of what I have given to Museo. It's what I've learned from everyone that I've been associated with, some incredible board of trustees members, executive directors, certainly with Jose. So many people have taught me so much over the years, and it's helped to make me a much better person. 21 years ago, we were so fortunate to have a conversation with Jose Aguayo and the Museo de las Americas as we were trying to locate a home for the Tragans Latin American folk art collection. It was apparent from the very beginning that this was the institution, the vision, the direction that was most compatible and compassionate and fit in with the wishes and the hopes for the Tragans.
I have to start in the Merced Market in Mexico City. Ellie and I were married in 1947. I had already been a student in Chile. But this was Ellie's first experience with Latin America. We went to the Merced Market, and we were living on a very tight budget. And there were days where we saw ceramics in the market that led us to give up buying food. There was such beauty in those pieces. Ellie and I, during our 50 plus years in the Foreign Service, became aficionados of the handicrafts and the master craftsmen throughout Latin America. And we weren't wealthy. We were just average, ordinary people who loved to go to the market, who loved to see the handicrafts, and throughout our married life, we accumulated what we could afford. And we finally got a collection of maybe 4,000 to 5,000 pieces. And we were looking for a home for our collection. We knew the Smithsonian was interested, but we knew it would go in a closet. Ellie and I, throughout all of our lifetime, had been working on building bridges, bridges of understanding between and among people. And with Jose, our conversation was about the interest of the Museo in building bridges between the Anglo and Latino and Hispanic community in the mountain states. When all things are said, the material without the spiritual means very little. And I can't conceive of a community like Denver without an institution like the Museo. And it is not to be underestimated the importance that an institution like this can make in the lives of people. It may be in size not that of the Denver Museum, but in its specialization, it can serve as an important tool for the whole culture of this area to come together. And the end of what all of us want is a peaceful, open, broadly based society in which all of us feel part. From Ellie and me to the Museo on its 30th birthday, our warmest good wishes and our expectations for a spectacular future.
We are grateful for all the dedication it took to create this amazing place. As Jose Aguayo passed the executive torch to the new leadership of Museo, they aim to present the rich diversity of Latino culture to the Museo visitors. Let's hear from Patty Ortiz about her role in shaping the Museo we know and love.
Art has the ability to reflect what's going on today. Art from Latin America really reflects what has happened in Latin America in a very refreshing way. I think artists of Latin America have told a story that has not been shown and it hasn't been at the forefront. And it is so needed because I think what is happening in South America is happening in the United States now. I urge people to come and see the really diverse stories that are being told by Latin American artists. I urge people to dive into the world of Latin America. It's so refreshing, it's so honest, it's so, it reveals a story that hasn't been told that needs to be recognized as part of our past. And actually, I think Latin American artists have been even more in the forefront of contemporary art because they have had the ability to be honest, much more honest about what's going on around them. I actually think there's a world of art made in Latin America that has never been seen before. And I think it's the Museo's responsibility to show that and to celebrate that and welcome people to see it. You know, it's not just for the other Latinos to see, it's for everyone to see. The Museo is at a pivotal point in its history and its life. because we are needed so much in our country right now to be that diverse voice, to be that welcoming place where people can feel different and be okay with being different. It's the only museum that focuses on Latin America, both history and contemporary, in this region. It's the place where you're going to experience that. I urge everyone to participate, to partake, to sit at the table with us and talk to us. The one thing that is true about Claudia is that she is really looking back at the previous directors and actually finding the best in all of us to kind of go forward. And I've never seen anybody do that. That is so unique to Claudia, that she is embracing all of the previous directors. And instead of just saying, I'm going to make my thing happen, she's actually seeing it as more of a holistic place and its past and its future. So it's a great perspective that I think is going to bring a lot to the Museo. Happy 30th anniversary to the Museo de las Americas.
Patti Ortiz connected Denver to Latin art and culture across the globe. That's a tradition that's still going on today. Text or donate the number below to support our upcoming exhibitions.
Civic engagement to me is the most lasting legacy anybody can leave. For me personally, I've been involved with civic engagement my whole life. I learned it from my family. I, along with many other people, started figuring out how can we make Museo de las Americas truly a unique place that people could feel comfortable coming from all different backgrounds, not just Latinos, but especially the minority communities of the Denver and the region, the Rocky Mountain region, because we needed that release. We needed to find ourselves. And I think Museo has been that for many, many people. An opportunity to find a safe haven, to be able to learn something new and different with the installations, the beautiful installations that the Museo offers. The arts have saved us in many, many ways. I truly believe that through the arts, we're able to release our inner being, we're able to find ourselves, and we're able to express ourselves in ways that nothing else compares. So I want that for my son. I want that for our kids. I want that for the next generation that have grown up here at the Museo through the summer camp program. One day we're going to turn over the keys to the Museo to Los Jóvenes. That to me would be my beautiful lasting legacy, that we were able to truly inspire those kids to take it on, to do the hard work, because it is not easy to run a museum of any size. I'm so proud of the summer camp program that started more than a decade ago, and it has grown into a magnificent opportunity for young kids, young children from the neighborhood and across the Denver area to be fully immersed in the wonderful programming that Museo designs for them every single summer. And those same youth have grown into, metamorphosized into the new program called Los Jóvenes. We were inspired many years ago by Mr. Irving Tragen, and he really put his money where his mouth is. And I want to do the same thing. I want to follow his leadership by contributing to the endowment fund that he started for the Museo de las Americas many years ago. We want also, after we're gone, for the Museo to continue its work in the community, and that's one thing that we know will happen.
Woo! Dang! This looks good, man. I love your work.
Thank you, man, appreciate it.
Wow, Museo does such a good job of supporting local and upcoming artists. And I know you've done a few things with them now. I know at the beginning of the pandemic, you were doing the live virtual show, right? And then also you did a featuring at a gift shop.
Yeah, I have some of my friends, some of my
Nice. Here. And now, of course, you're helping out with the 30th anniversary.
Yeah.
So good to see that, man. And if you all want to help out and support, make sure you go ahead and bid for this piece of art. Such an incredible piece of art to keep helping and supporting local and emerging artists. Such incredible work. What do y'all think, y'all?
I think it's pretty good, man. Like, it's halfway done, but the style of it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I just love the
colors. The colors.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Pretty. I like the fade for the skeletons.
And now it's time to wish all our friends a happy birthday. How do we wish a happy birthday in Espanol?
¡Feliz cumpleaños!
Say with me one more time, happy birthday!
Wow, what an incredible piece by Jules. If you're interested in checking out more of his art, please check out his Instagram page. But don't forget, this piece is still up for sale, so go bid.
Anybody else feel like dancing?
You don't have to tell me twice.
These kids are the future generation of art. Maybe it's because they attend the Museo de las Americas summer camp. Under Maruca's leadership, museos deepened its connection with families and became a place where people of all ages were welcomed. If you like the work that Museo is doing, click the link below the description to place a bid on Julio's piece or some of the other incredible pieces we're auctioning to raise funds for the Museo's next 30 years.
Why people should visit Museo is because we are humans. Smart humans like to challenge themselves to new experiences, new adventures of the mind, and also because knowing your neighbor, you can be able to have a better relationship with other human beings. If you have never visited Museo de las Americas, just go see what's happened there. What are they doing? What are these crazy Mexicans or Latinos are doing over there? And you will be pleasantly surprised. The warmth, the beauty, the love, the familiarity that you will feel when you enter the walls of Museo. We have a lot to offer. And you will enjoy what we have here. You will definitely have fun with us. I believe that this is the time. This is the time that we can ask for more and we can get more. And this is the time that I want to see Museo grow in a way that is physical. Because we have grown spiritually a great deal, but we need to grow physically. We need to move from the space and become what we always needed to be. The greatest Museo of Latino Art in the Southwest of the United States. And it's ours. The respect, the tradition is ours. We need to align ourselves with people who not only believe that this institution makes sense for the future, because we do. We have something that nobody does. We have the capacity to be able to see this continent as a whole. We see this country as one, and we see no borders. And we see no barriers because we are all border crossers. Not one of us is not, whether it's mental borders or spiritual borders or sexual borders. And with that idea, with that ideology in mind, the help that we need to grow and to be bigger, it's available. And it will be more available in the future because people's hearts are changing. What I envision Museo in the future is that we have a brand new space and we create a state-of-the-art
Museo de las Americas, they will house not only pre-Columbian exhibitions, but it will house also folk art of the Southwest, that we showcase Chicano art, that we showcase contemporary Latinx art. You know, that's what I envision, to have that kind of sense of unity.
As I became more familiar with the museo as a board member, I got to meet certain people who were extremely generous with their involvement with the museo. And one person in particular is Irving Tragen. He set up an endowment for the museo that was guaranteed to bring in around $750,000 throughout his giving efforts at that time. And what that did for us is establish a base for developing and growing money, which is certainly the lifeblood of any organization. When Maruca was hired as the executive director of the museo, what was very clear was that she brought a breadth of talent and understanding of the museo that a lot of us didn't. I looked at her as kind of the motherhead of our museum. She could do everything. And many times in a nonprofit, you have to have somebody who can do that. She really brought a holistic approach and meaning to what it is to be an executive director. Every time I saw a new exhibit, I was overwhelmed at the brilliance. You know, I look at this and it's like, well, what can they do to improve? And then they come back, they take everything down, they get ready for a new exhibit, and things I would never have thought of. It brings a whole new life to the space we're in. It's amazing when you go back to starting from Patty Ortiz, Maruca Salazar, and now Claudio Moran. I'm just constantly amazed at the great work that they do. And that only makes the board look good. The thing that I was most impressed with is that there was just an immense amount of talent. You know, people who cared enough to work for a nonprofit for not a lot of money. And what they brought, enthusiasm, they brought great ideas, they brought vision. And so to see all this come together as a whole family of Latinos involved with art and culture, and to see it grow year to year, I think that that's one of the things that really engendered my enthusiasm for being involved with the museo.
That was powerful. Click the link below in the description to support a child with an art kit for $25. The current executive director, Claudia Moran, has been a key part of establishing Museo as one of the best places to experience art in Denver, especially within the Art District of Santa Fe, and has built a museum that maintains a balance of ancient, folk, and contemporary art with an inclusive approach that makes Latino art and culture accessible to all. Let's listen.
Museo's responsibility is to include the different voices. We want to present and balance all the programs and exhibitions that we have because we want those voices to be represented. Museo's responsibility is to keep the doors open, to have a respectful conversation. We're very proud to be in the Art District on Santa Fe. And that's how Museo became an anchor organization in the district. Museo was primarily opening doors for other artists and arts organizations to come and be part of this wonderful neighborhood right now. I wanted to say thank you to all the former directors of Museo. José Aguayo founded an outstanding organization that has been incredible to many. Patty transformed Museo into a new space. And Maruca was able to connect this organization to everyone. I want to say thank you to all of them because the lessons that I have learned are very unique and have been supportive for my new role in this organization. But I also want to thank you all the donors that have been here for the longest, that have transitioned from director to director, because they have understood that we are not just presenting a director. And I also want to thank you, foundations, because they are here creating new programs, exciting us to move forward, but also creating stability. And stability is essential for small nonprofit organizations. And I want to say thank you to all the corporations because they really bring that spark and new faces and new engagements that really make us think about new things. And I want to thank you to all the community members. You are the most important. Everything we do in this space is for you. Without you, none of this would be possible. We are here for that. We serve you. You know, we are a public servers here. And that's why we want to see you here, because you are the most important. And cultivating younger generations is our goal, and we'll continue doing that. Thank you to all of you. Thank you to all the supporters, past, current, and future for Museo Las Americas. Thank you.
Hearing the tales of Museo makes me so happy. Let's take a break and celebrate Museo's birthday with a performance from international artist Monsieur Perine.
This is Monsieur Perine from Bogota, Colombia. Thank you for hearing us, and this is our music.
Vivo fingiendo un sueño que no se cuenta. Vivo imaginándote, solo imaginándote, pero el amor se escapa aunque yo te mienta. Yo estaba buscándote, sola aquí esperándote, y tú mirándome sin hablar, y yo hablándote sin mirar. Y tú, no sé lo que estás sintiendo, pero yo me estoy muriendo. Perdernos esta noche, bailar contigo sin que importe nadie más. Bailar contigo en la arena y los tambores. Tienes la llama que enciende mi alma y nos hace volar. Bailando en las olas contigo, un barco de papel te quiero regalar para que vengas conmigo, bailando en las olas conmigo. Y tú mirándome sin hablar, y yo hablándote sin mirar. Y tú ya sé lo que estás sintiendo, ya sabes que estoy muriendo, no aguanto más.
Bailar contigo
y perdernos esta noche. Bailar contigo sin que importe nadie más. Bailar contigo en la arena y los tambores. Tienes la llama que enciende mi alma y nos hace volar. Cuando bailas brillas. brillan las estrellas, todas se derriten sobre el mar, espuma sobre el mar. Sigo caminando tras tus huellas, y aunque se derritan en el mar,
yo te voy a encontrar.
Bailar contigo y perdernos esta noche, bailar contigo sin que importe nadie más.
Bailar contigo
en la arena y los tambores, tienes la llama que enciende mi alma y nos hace volar.
Saludos a las personas que están hoy acompañándonos. Nosotros somos Monsieur Perine desde Colombia, desde Bogotá, y estamos muy felices, muy orgullosos de poder compartir nuestra música en esta celebración tan especial para el Museo de las Américas y toda su comunidad en Denver, Colorado.
Sigue en la calle hasta mi casa. Aquí se quedó y estamos los dos saltando en una pata. Tengo un jardín pequeño que florece y me da pa' fumar cada 6 meses. Yo no pido más, es la vida que uno se merece. La cosa es sencilla, ver cómo el sol brilla, correr sin zapatos, bañarse en la orilla, bailar bajo la lluvia y el viento que me arrulla. Pa' que otra boca si ya tengo. Del cielo, aquí lo que se cae lo paramos del suelo. Lo material es lo segundo, el amor es lo primero. Aquí la realidad parece un sueño, aquí no hay reyes ni tampoco dueños. Se cultiva el campo con canciones para alimentar los corazones. La cosa es sencilla, ver cómo el sol brilla, correr sin zapatos, bañarse en la orilla, bailar bajo la lluvia y el viento que me arrulla. Pa' que otra boca si ya tengo. Tengo poco, pero tengo todo lo que
necesito para darme
cariñito. Tengo poco en este mundo, loco, y aunque sea poquito, mi mundo es bonito.
No busco nada, ya lo encontré, una sonrisa y una taza.
It's been amazing meeting all of the directors of Museo, from 1991 to 2021, I'd like to introduce two of Museo's staff members, Shanae and Simone, who are going to present some awards to very deserving individuals in the community.
Thank you, Hoser. Our Legacy Award honors an innovative artist, a generous philanthropist, or a creative leader whose support furthers Museo's mission. This year, we're going to honor Emmanuel Martinez in recognition for his long-term support of Museo de las Americas. As one of the founding fathers of Museo, Emmanuel was able to curate Emmanuel Martinez, a retrospective, one of Museo's first exhibitions. Most recently, he refurbished our replica pyramid of Uxmal that is featured in our newly reopened Ancient American Gallery. Gracias, Emmanuel, for all that you've done for us and for our community. To our viewers at home, text the number below to support our upcoming exhibitions.
Well, I am honored to receive this prestigious Legacy Award from the Museo de las Americas Board of Directors. It is my honor to be one of the founding members of the Museo, along with Jose Aguayo, whose leadership for 12 years put us on the map as the only museum in the Rocky Mountain region focusing exclusively on the art, history, and culture of Latinos in the Americas from Mesoamerica to the present. Thanks again for the award.
To our viewers at home, be like Emmanuel and support the Museo. Text or donate the number below and support our upcoming exhibitions.
Thank you so much, Emmanuel. I'm proud to present the Corazón de la Educación Award. This award honors an encouraging teacher, a strong community leader, a connected partner, or a generous donor who furthers our education department's important mission. And the recipient of this year's award, Paula Ramirez, is truly at the heart of our education programming success. She's a parent, a volunteer, and a fierce advocate for Museo's educational programs and our kiddos. Felicidades, Paula. Thank you so much for all that you do for us and for our familias. And for viewers at home, please click on the link and sponsor a child to attend Museo's Summer Art and Culture Camp. For $350, you may be able to provide a summer camp experience that a child would otherwise not have.
Muchísimas gracias a Museo. Thank you, Museo, for this unexpected surprise. I am so grateful and honored to be accepting this award. I believe that it's really important for our children to learn about the beauty of their roots and to learn about their history in the United States and in the Americas. And so I think it's important for us to continually support museums like Museo and other organizations that allow our children to learn about their roots and then express the past, the present, and the future for themselves. Thank you so much. Muchísimas gracias.
Museo supports our community, and our community supports Museo. Check out all the peeps who came through to wish us a happy birthday.
Bobby Lefebvre here, Colorado's Poet Laureate, wanting to wish the Museo de las Americas a very, very happy 30th birthday. The Museo is one of my favorite institutions in the entire city. And whether I am working with the Museo directly in collaboration on something or just serving as a visitor, I'm always blown away by the incredible and beautiful things that the Museo showcases in our city throughout the Americas. Centering Latino identity and cultures in a way that we really can't get anywhere else. So thank you to the Museo, to the staff, to everyone who makes the place run for creating this amazing institution in our city. And again, wish you a very, very happy 30th birthday. Here's to 30 more.
Hola, my name is Cal Duran, a local artist, an educator, spirit keeper, and ancestor charmer. And I just want to say gracias and happy birthday to Museo de las Americas. Thank you for cultivating artists and giving back to the community.
Happy birthday, Museo!
Hi, I'm Marcia Romero, Community Affairs at US Bank here in Denver. Happy birthday, Museo. And on behalf of US Bank, we thank you for creating a vibrant platform for the Latino arts in our community. Muchas gracias.
Hola, I'm Colorado Governor Jared Polis. Colorado's only Latin American art museum, Museo de las Americas, is turning 30 years old. Located at the heart of the Santa Fe Arts District, Museo has been putting the color in Colorado for 3 decades now. Thank you for your vision and leadership to make our state more diverse, equitable, and inclusive of our celebrated Latino art and culture. Felicitaciones, congratulations. I look forward to what you accomplish in the next 30 years. Feliz cumpleaños, Museo.
Happy 30th birthday, Museo. This is Nancy Walsh at the Denver Museum of Nature and Science, and I am so grateful for everything that you bring into my life and the ways in which you make our entire community more artful. Happy birthday.
Hi, I'm Gary Stoyer, President and CEO of the Bonfils Stanton Foundation. I want to wish Museo de las Americas a big happy birthday on its 30th anniversary. We have been supporting Museo for so many years and have many other connections as well. Maruca served on our board of directors. Claudia is now one of our Livingston fellows. And just about a year ago, we became neighbors on Santa Fe. The work of Museo is so important to our community, and we are so grateful for what you do. And on behalf of the staff and board of Bonfils Stanton Foundation, happy 30th anniversary, Museo.
Hola. My name is Paz, and I am the executive director and co-founder of the Apprentice of Peace Youth Organization. And I'm here today to say happy birthday to Museo, to Claudia, and the whole team. Congratulations. Thank you for all of your service, for all of your hard work, and all that you do for community. What an awesome celebration. Congratulations on 30 years. Happy birthday.
Feliz cumpleaños, Museo de las Americas. This is Michael Sattler, Executive Director of the Rocky Mountain Arts Association and its member choruses, the Denver Gay Men's Chorus and the Denver Women's Chorus. We have been thrilled to partner with you these past several years, doing everything from exhibiting pieces from your priceless exhibits at our Fiesta for All show at the Ellie Cockins Opera House, to singing at the Dias de los Muertos celebration that you sponsor. Happy 30th anniversary for being a vibrant part of our cultural and art scene, and here's to many, many more years of success.
Feliz cumpleaños, Museo de las Americas. It feels like yesterday when I was working there and we celebrated quinceañera. You have grown so much and have become a cornerstone of the Denver cultural fabric. Thank you for bringing the arts from the Americas to Denver and for all you have done for the community. Felicidades.
Hello, I'm Kristen Crampton Day, Executive Director of Colorado Business Committee for the Arts, CBCA. Happy 30th birthday, Museo de las Americas. With only about a dozen museums across the country like Museo, Denver in Colorado is fortunate to have a museum dedicated to preserving and exhibiting the diverse cultures of the Americas, from ancient to present day, through innovative exhibitions and educational programming. Your bright pink building stands out as a gem of our Santa Fe Arts District and is a community hub to residents and visitors alike. Thank you for all you do, Museo, and happy birthday.
Happy birthday
to you.
Happy birthday
to you.
Happy birthday. There's a high note.
Happy birthday.
Feliz Felicidades, Museo. We love you. We are
better
with you than without you.
Felicidades. Muchas gracias por representar a nuestra comunidad.
Thank you to everyone who made this video celebration possible, and to all the people out there who are donating and contributing to the art auction, so we can make Museo's next 30 as good as the first 30. It's not too late. You can still text to donate and bid on our auction items until midnight on June 8th. Have a good night, everybody. Peace.
Feliz cumpleaños to our beloved Museo de las Americas.
Hey.